Let's go through question number 12 from chapter 9. So the question says, consider the following hypothesis test. Our null hypothesis is that mu is greater than or equal to 80, and our alternative hypothesis is that mu is less than 80. Then a sample of 100 is used and the population standard deviation is 12. Compute the p-value and state your conclusion for each of the following sample results. And our alpha is going to be 0.01. So we have two different parts of this problem. The first part, our x bar will be 78.5, then our x bar will change and become 77. So let's work with x bar being 78.5 first. So if we need to compute a p-value, the first step that we need to do is find a z-score. So our z-score formula is x bar, which is 78.5, minus mu null, which that will just be our 80, all over sigma, which is 12, divided by the square root of n, which is 100. So we can plug all of that into our z-score formula. That then simplifies down into negative 1.5 over 1.2. When you do that math, you'll see that your z-score ends up as negative 1.25. So we'll use this z-score, this test statistic, in order to find our p-value. So we have our bell curve, and we put our z-score of negative 1.25 on our bell curve. Now, we need to know, is this a right-tailed test, a left-tailed test? So we look up at the sign in our alternative hypothesis, and we see that it's pointed to the left, so it's a left-tailed test. So when we look up our z-score of negative 1.25 in our table, we will find the area to the left of that z-score, and that area becomes 0.1056. And that 0.1056 is your p-value. So now we can figure out what our conclusion would be. So the rule that we have is that if the p-value is less than or equal to alpha, we reject the null. So our p-value is 0.1056, our alpha is 0.01, and so since our p-value is greater than alpha, we do not reject the null hypothesis. So now if we change it up and say that our x-bar is 77, the process still remains the same. We still need to find a z-score, a test statistic, in order to find a p-value. So we plug in everything that we know. Our x-bar is 77, mu null is still 80, sigma is still 12, and n is still 100. So our z-score formula simplifies down into negative 3 over 1.2. giving us a z-score of negative 2.5. So we have our bell curve once again. We put our z-score of negative 2.5 on there. And we need to figure out which tail we're working with. So we go up to the alternative hypothesis and see that the sign is pointed to the left. So once again, it's a left-tailed test. So we need the area to the left of the negative 2.5 z-score. That area will be 0.0062. And again, that area is your p-value. So when we need to find our conclusion here, our p-value is 0.0062. Our alpha is still 0.01. So since our p-value is less than our alpha, we reject our null hypothesis.